What's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 9 of Garden of Glass. We are going so fast. It's already episode 9, and we're getting so much stuff done. I was actually just having a look how funny it is. Two episodes ago, we were still in our cobblestone, disgusting base, and now look at this. How cool is that? That is beautiful. I love it. I'm really loving this. I really, really do. So, we have got a few things to show you, and I wanted to state the obvious. We've got a texture pack on. It's changing pretty much nothing but the clouds, which is exactly what I asked for. Thank you so much for the suggestions. And I like it. I really like this one. This was suggested by DoubleAF1. And it's a resource pack that's on Minecraft forums. I'll put the link down in the description. It's called Extremely Realistic Clouds Pack. And I'm willing to vouch for him. They're pretty realistic. I like it. Kind of like how the sun's got like that kind of a thing. It's not super realistic, the sun, but I mean, hey. We didn't want the super realistic sun. We asked for super realistic clouds, and that's what we got. That's exactly what we got. Now we've got a few other things to do. I haven't done too much, actually, since the last episode. But we are still waiting for this grass to grow around here. It's slowly spreading. And the reason we haven't made ourselves a new pasture seed is because we haven't got enough grass. We haven't got enough bone meal or bones to make bone meal to bone meal grass to get pasture seeds. So that is that. Now, with this part over here, I'll quickly show you what we've done, what I have done. I've built this little thing here. I don't think it's going to stay too long, but I've made it look nice, just in case. Just leave it around here looking a bit good. I've put that in because I know I'm going to one day fall off that. And that's just my thing that I was talking about, the little mob spawner. I don't know whether it's going to work. I know this looks really bright, but if you look here, all spawnable. And we've been getting a few spawns, but not much really, although that's been there for about 10 minutes now, so that could be why. We're still waiting on a few of these trees to grow, and if you have a look, you might notice. I never actually knew this had particle effects on it as well. That was pretty cool. We've got this extended out 2 more blocks that way, and I just thought that would make sure they would definitely grow. I might have to do something else about it because that tree over there is not growing. Might have to just destroy a few leaves. We'll try that, but yep, this was definitely a good update. All these trees seem to be working. Thank you guys at Botanical Add-ons. That is really, really cool. And this side over here, we've got the same thing with that tree there. I'm really liking this Botanical Add-ons area. We'll get into more Botanical Add-ons stuff sometime soon. But today we've got something a bit out of the way of Botanical Add-ons, but that's alright. Because that stuff will still be there. So I've got to get rid of that at some stage. It's really gross. Right around here, we're going to be building something which is going to look pretty awesome. So if you have a look, actually, I'll try and explain to you what we're doing. So if you see this part here, we've started on it. I want this base to kind of look like in the shape of a kind of flower. So if you have a look, that's kind of like a petal. You can see how it's going to work its way around there. I don't know how I'm actually going to do it. It's going to be interesting, but it's worth a try. I mean, if it doesn't turn out, it'll still look cool anyway. Whatever we're doing will look pretty awesome, I'm sure. But that's the plan for that. Now with this area over here, this is just going to be a kind of park in the middle, but it's also going to serve as our flower farm because we don't have a flower farm, and we may as well make one. I mean, it's one of the early things that would come in really handy. And that reminds me. Let's have a look here. I was also having a look at some crafting crates. So, there could be something coming up, but we don't know. Okay, so have a look in... What was I doing? Oh, I was going to do this. We're going to look in the Botania challenges. Now, we've done already something here. So if you have a look at this, let me just take my ring off, which we can fix this as well today. So, around here, this is our... Well, I mean, it's a pure daisy farm, but really it is almost a cobble generator. But, what we can do is if we turn off this part over here, so if we turned off one of these, so for instance, that over there, if we took all of the sand out of that, that makes this a smooth stone farm. Because that just means anything that comes down here will automatically just get broken, it will just fall on there, and we can just get it to get picked up in a chest if we really wanted to. But that's a smooth stone farm. Now we can also make this into a actual just normal stone farm. And the way you can do, oh, it's cobblestone farm, sorry. The way you can do that is either put a ball ends up there, or you can even just leave this here and just take away the pure daisy. I mean, that's exactly how that works. So I think we can start checking off some stuff in our book. So the flower farm, I'm thinking we're going to get done today. The record farm is a pretty easy farm, but I don't really see how I would do it without the, I mean, I'm probably overlooking something right now, but without the spawning tower, because I want to do that and hook that in all as one big thing. So that will probably be a while. Then we've got the cobble generator, which, if you have a look, it's created an augmented cobblestone generator and harvester. which we kind of just explained. We've kind of gone one step further, and then we've taken it one step back. So, bonus points if it also creates smooth stone without a furnace. There are no furnaces around here. So we've got that out of the way. Now, the next one was a auto pure daisy. Pure daisy, bonus points if only one spreader is used, and or the wood or stone input is also automated. So we kind of got half the bonus points there. We aren't only using one mana spreader. I can use just one mana spreader. I don't really want to use just one mana spreader, but I mean, we can do it. This is just a really good looking design. Now, the way we would use one mana spreader would be, I think, if I remember correctly, because I haven't actually tested around with this farm in a long time, but if we got some other lenses, like I think an efficiency lens would do it. I always forget which lens is which, but that would be able to go all the way through. So if we made a composite efficiency lens or whatever, like something like that. Oh, wait, we can do a composite one of them. I think we would need a mana prism. That's right. We'd need a mana prism with one of the lenses on. And yeah, that would work. I think it's a bit of playing around, but I can't remember which way it was. So that's how we would do it with just one. We can maybe do that one day, but currently I'm going to mark completed, but no bonus points on that. I wish it was a bonus point ticker. A mana battery. Now, that's something I just did about a few days ago. And I think that would be... Do they actually... They don't actually fall. Cool. And I did it a few days ago. I think that would be pretty cool to get done. I mean, it's pretty simple. We can get one of them out of the way soon. And these over here, we haven't got any of these. We've kind of got the orchid. We can put one of them in pretty soon. And I think that's about it. So at the end of the day, we want to have that ticked off. And I also want to take that one step further, but we can do that maybe another day, maybe today. We'll see how we go. Now, something else I wanted to show you, and you wouldn't have, may have noticed it. I don't actually know if it's kind of sticking out, but I'm talking about my hat, guys. So if I go around here, there, yeah, you can't see anything. And from this angle, you can't see anything. So we've also got another person who has helped us out, and that is a person called Digzator on Twitter. Thank you very much, by the way. Thank you for this. Let me show you. We've got a hat. We got a Santa hat, which is something I wanted to do. So that's helped me out a lot. It's all just a Santa hat. The rest of the outfit's still the same. But thank you so much. And it's OMB, and it's at Digzator on Twitter. So thank you so much for that. It's pretty awesome. Now, what I want to do is something else that is kind of a tenuary, which I'm sure some of you guys might have saw coming when I took my hat off, is we may as well, for the time during Christmas now, because I mean it is pretty much Christmas now, we can get ourselves some phantom ink. Now, I don't know whether or not I can craft this just yet. I know we need a mana pearl, so we've got a mana pearl, we just need some dye and some glass bottles. Now, I don't have glass, so I'll put some of that in a furnace. Wait, do we have enough sand? We don't have enough sand. We'll get that sorted, and I'll be back with that a bit later. Now, for today, I've also just let you know I've just extended that down that way as well. So for today, we can get started on that flower farm, and I'm thinking that'll be pretty good around here. Now, I've just got to get a few materials, and I'll show you, and we can build it together and see how this goes. So I'll be right back with these materials, and I really just can't get over how cool the sky looks. Just quickly, I'll ramble on and digress, but this sky is just so awesome. Like, look at it. It's just crazy. Like, the stars are awesome. The moon, even that even changes. That's pretty cool. Like, the only thing which is on my side, not on this texture pack side, is because we're in a skyblock, you've always got that like awkward angle there. But once we fill in a lot of this stuff, it would look pretty damn cool. I think we wouldn't even notice. Well, we shouldn't notice that. So that's something we will see in the future. This looks pretty cool, I'm just saying. So that's it for that, and I'll be back right now. So it's morning time. I have just gone and got a few things. We've only got two pasture seeds, and it's the vivid ones that we're using because that just looks so damn awesome. What we're going to do is kind of, because I'm thinking like this area, because we're going to start expanding outward, we can maybe make like a bit of a parky type thing in here. And I don't know, I think that'll look pretty cool. So the plan is, I'm going to go around and try this. Now, I don't know how this will work. I will stress that I am not really that much of a builder. So let's have a look at how well this is going to go. So we go four out there. We've got another one there. I need this around here, don't I? So one there, one there. Oh, yeah, I'm holding shift. I'd rather just lose them and hold shift. We've got too many of them now, so that's all right. We'll just do that. And there. So that's kind of three. I don't know if I'm doing the right... Oh, damn it. I don't even have that. It's not because I'm holding shift. It's because I don't even have the ring on. And we've already run out of stuff. Oh my gosh. So disorganized. There we go. We'll go grab some more. And now I've just put the ring on. Now I'm going to have to take it off again. Arr, there we go. So we'll get a few of those. And now, let's see how we go. Put that ring on. And over here. So we'll just fill this area up here. And we'll start going at one block each time. Oh, that's too many blocks. So like that. Now we can just fill in this area here. Kind of border it around with the brick. I love this brick. I really do use it too much. I mean, every tutorial, I use this brick. Now, that's got to be three wide when it comes there, because I want to keep this three wide thing going on over there. So if this area is here, now this is exactly what goes through my mind when I'm busy building these things. So, you can see, I'm trying to work stuff out. Now, I don't think there's a technical way to build stuff, so that's the problem. I'm sure there is actually a technical way to build things, but I don't really know how to do it very well. So I kind of just wing it and hope for the best. And I think it's turned out alright for us. I think so. So that there, we can maybe make that out one more. And then kind of go here. Now, will that work? Yeah, I think that works. I think that's alright. Now we'll fill this area in, and I'll just fill in up to there, and then we can start doing the rest, and then we'll come back and fill up all this stuff. Because this isn't really fun. This isn't the fun, exciting stuff. So what we're going to do is in this park, I haven't worked out the shape. Maybe we can make it like a compass type thing. I don't know, like a fairly large compass. Well, is this, which area? This is east. I think maybe not. It would be cool if we did it in the middle or like north or south, but east kind of just seems awkward to put a compass. So maybe we'll just do a small design maybe then. And we'll use that for another idea a bit later, maybe. Maybe. Another idea is, I'm thinking we're going to be building that mob spawning tower at some stage, but I want to get a few towers kind of popping up all over the place, get some like cool looking stuff, kind of like that. So that could be an idea for the future, but not today, obviously. But I just thought that was a good idea. I thought I'd let you know this. So, there. Now, with the jaded amaranthus, which is what we're going to be using for our flower farm, that requires it to be in the middle, and it needs, well, it doesn't need, but it can go up to four blocks on either side, and I think that's a really good idea. So what we can do is, I also want to try and hide the drum. That's a challenge. So we'll try and hide the drum away, because we're going to have a drum of the, is it not the gathering, let me have a look. What's the drum called? I always forget these things. The first one, is it of the wild? Thought that was too simple. It popped into my head. I was like, it's not the Drum of the Wild. There's nowhere near the Drum of the Wild. It was the Drum of the Wild. Okay, cool. So that there. Go out. And we'll finish this off now. So we'll have a look at where we get the first blocks of four blocks. So let me try that. And that there. Now, the first time we get four, well, if that made sense to you. So the first time we get four blocks out on either side. So here we got four blocks there. So that's the first one where we got four blocks. So it can kind of go out there. So that's easy. So if we go the way I've done that, if you understand what's going through my mind. So the first time that has got four blocks out. So it's that one over there goes out four blocks there. Now we need to go four more blocks that way. Then we can place a jaded amaranthus down and have it using all the area. So one, two, I'm so scared with these. Three, four. I saved myself a bit earlier, and I don't know if it was just because I finished up my mana that it kind of messed up, but it was when I was doing some stuff there. This it was the quickest rod of disguising I've ever done. I fell off, and I've just kept that on number two on my hotbar there, so I can quickly just boom like that. So if I did fall, I forgot. It does save you. So yeah, that's the trick. If you do fall, quickly just make sure it's on your hotbar and click as quick as possible. Click everything. Just hope for the best. But yeah, if you're too late, you just don't make it. Now, that seems like it should be alright. I'll continue that outwards, and we can have like a kind of parky type thing going on here, but we need to go get ourselves... Well, we're going to be doing a bit of infusion or runic altering or whatever you want to call it. Actually, I can put these out. Let's put these out. Because they can start spreading around. We'll just put one because there's no rush. And by the way, I have tested this out. I tested this out just a few minutes ago, actually. When we place this down, this will also grow flowers from the jaded amaranthus on it. So, not to worry, that will work. I've tested it. Kind of feel it's a bit flat. Probably should have done that up one block, down one block. That's all right. We can do something else that makes it a bit more, like, three-dimensionally, I don't know. Pops it out a little bit. Now, what we need for the... Let's get it out here. So we need the jaded amaranthus. Why am I going to there? We're going into there. So the jaded amaranthus. It requires a redstone root, which is actually a problem for us right now, unless we've got a skeleton in there. We need a rune of spring, which isn't a problem. We just have to make it. But that redstone root is the only thing which could cause us grief. Now, let's hope there's a skeleton in here and there's absolutely nothing. I've done something, I'm sure, that's making this a little bit less efficient. But that's alright. We can just wait for that skeleton. That's fine. Now, what else we can do is we can have a look at what we're going to do. I can't remember the name of this flower. That'll allow us to have our magnet on, but not get anything picked up, which is pretty cool. What was it? It wasn't those. Not the tangleberry. What does the tangleberry do? Yeah, that's... I thought so. There. I don't know. Now, it's the... No. Yeah, the Solgonia. The Solignolia? I think that's it, Solignolia? We'll call it that. So, what this does is, because we've got the ring of the ring of magnetization on, when this is around, and I'm pretty sure this can be it can be redstone powered. By the way, if you guys ever wanted to know if a flower is redstone powered, with the exception of the orchid, this rule applies. The orchid in Garden of Glass doesn't apply to this rule, but it works. With this redstone root, if it's got a redstone root in it, it will be able to be switched on and off by redstone. So, that's just something if someone didn't know that. Pretty cool. And the orchid does normally have one, I'm pretty sure, in the normal recipe, but not in Garden of Glass. So, that's pretty easy. We just need that grass as well with that. And that should be pretty simple. So, it'll just be put down. We'll make a floating variant of it. Place it around there, and we'll also place one there. So, we'll make a few of them, actually, probably. And get those out the way. And then what we can do today is also just kind of do what we're doing here. I don't know whether I'm going to do it, but let's see how we go. Do that around there. Do it around a few things so that we don't fall off the edges. And yeah, we'll see how we go for today. And I'm still in love with these clouds. That is so cool. I think it compliments us really good. But and that's enough of that. And I'll be back right now. We may have a rogue skeleton. Or maybe one's just come in here. I've kind of just popped back. This is like a few... probably like 2 minutes after signing off. Look at that cloud. But I just picked up a bone. And I don't know where the skeleton is. Hello? Hello? Knock, knock. No skeletons. I picked it up from over here, which is what makes me a little bit worried. Maybe if it was out, it went in there. Let me push F7. There's no spawnable spots around here. I've, like, made sure of that. Yeah, I don't know what's going on there. I thought maybe we could have a skeleton fight. Turns out there's nothing. False alarm. I thought I'd record it. It might be funny. Okay, so I've just woken up. I've just slept away. Look at what just happened. I forgot to put torches out. No, 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 no. Okay, they're coming. You're not going to shoot me, are you? Oh, you got refuge under there? No, you don't. No, you don't. Not up in here. Come on. Oh, you think you're tough with your armor? Yep. Maybe want the experience or whatever. Die, creeper, you can go all the way there. And I've got knockback on my sword, which is awesome. I normally don't like knockback, but in this situation, it's awesome. There we go. We're good. And that's also kind of lucky, because I did... Oh, four bones. That is awesome. We've got... We're set. There's no worries from here on. So, I've already just done one thing with that bone that I found out there, literally a minute ago. So, we've got enough of this now to make ourselves some redstone stuff. And we need, let's do five of them. And then also have to have a look for my, oh wow, I've got so much crap in here. Let me just clear out. There's like next to nothing's cleared out. Because everything Those unconnected. So here we go. Let's try that again. Go five of those, and we'll get five of those. Oh, six of those. Did I say five? I mean six. What else do we need? We needed our runic altar, which is in here. Now, this is going to be a bit of a setup thing. I might just set this up off camera. Okay, so I think I'm ready to come back to this. So this was also only a little bit later. I've got all this stuff out. I had to make a new elven mana spreader, which is awesome. We can get going with this rune. So that should be... Is that all we needed? We needed something else, I'm sure. What is it? That was the jaded amaranthus that needed that one. We'll just search that up. And this is a pretty cool feature I want to show you guys as well. This has just been added in the most recent update, this NEI plugin, so not that. Have a look there. Plugin, I don't know what to call it. But yeah, that's pretty cool. It's got some stuff written about the flowers on here. Kind of cool. Just thought you guys would like to see that. And we will go back to this. So around there, oh, we need some wheat. And how convenient. We get some wheat. So we need to get ourselves one of these. Now, with that, the grass has started spreading. We'll build that out completely. But I don't know. I don't think we're going to do all too much today. I wonder if my ring definitely doesn't work on that. That's cool. Now, oh yeah, we get those back. I forget about that. Now that we've got those, we can... I've got that in there. Cool. We'll just make one of the Solignolias when we do get to it. So that's one of those. Not lucky to get the right one. We need one of those and one of those, I think. One of those and one of those. Was it? No? Oh, we're forgetting the one thing that we came here for specifically was that. So one of those. And now we should be able to do it. So if we just do one like that, got our jaded amaranthus. Now the solignolias was one of those. Oh, that's not going to work. I need to do that first. So one of them, two of those, and there was something else. What was the other thing? Oh, one of those. Like that. Now that should work. So we just drop that in. And we've got all of them in here now. So there's a solignolia. We can maybe just plant that on the ground. Maybe, I don't know, maybe, I don't know, I'm just saying stuff. Now you'll see, that should start, it's not working, I'm not picking it up. Okay, cool, I didn't realize I could come this close without it picking up. So we'll do that, maybe, place it around there, just for now, we'll place that there. And now this shouldn't pick up anything. I think I've just picked up something here, but that's alright. We can come around this way, and I still have not learnt my lesson, so there aren't any torches up. Now, this is where we said there was four, right? So, in line with where we last had that. So, one, two, three, four, five. So, five is the middle, and that would be good. So, I think we'll have to work a way of hiding the mana pool in a tree, maybe. Maybe we can have some trees around here or something. I don't know, make it exciting, make it different. And then we also will have a bunch of chests and stuff, which will have all these flowers. Now, one of the bonus points for this one was, let me stand this way, one of them was to, I think, sort your flowers, not the achievements, but that's something else we can have a look into. But here, so bonus points if the flowers are sorted, and I think that's pretty easy for me. I don't actually have a problem with that. So we will need 16 item frames, which if that tells you exactly how we're going to do it, we'll need 16 item frames, 4 hopper hocks, and I could even go one step further and make them into, I mean, we could just... Yeah, let's go one step further. That's why I was looking at those crafter crates a bit earlier. We could just make them into petals. So once the petals back up, it'll go into something else and go into something else. So petals back up into the hopper. That'll be good. Yeah, we can do that. So I will get to doing that. We may have to set up our orchid again. And I don't want to do that, actually. So I might just set it up over there and do a kind of half job there. Eventually, I want to set it up all the way down that way. Because... you guys heard how loud that was, and I don't want that around here, so we'll set it up on the other side of the park or whatever. But for now, I will get to going with some of that stuff, and I'll be right back. Alrighty, we're back again, and this time probably will be the biggest update. Well, it's nothing amazing, it's just pretty cool. So if you have a look here, it's turning nighttime now, that's alright. We've just extended a bit of this out, and extended a bit of that out, so... the idea is we're going to have our flower farm around here, and flowers are going to sprout out around all over the place here. So we're going to have to create a bit of storage, and I've got some stuff ready for us to do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to need 16 item frames, and that's obviously because we need 16... Oh man, we didn't bring enough wood. That's alright. We've got 8 for now, we can do the rest a bit later. So what I want to do is we're going to need 8 hop hocks. And the way this kind of system that I'm doing here will work is we want to also have it a bit hidden because we don't really want that to be seen. So if we go out 1, 2, 3, 4, then we can go 2 more back. And oh, I can't really jump now, can I? Oh, I can do it like this. And I don't know how this is going to turn out if I hold shift and jump, jump. Okay, that worked. That worked. So we need to go a column up like that, 4, 4, 4. And that'll work out to be 16, like once we get that last column in. I'll do that last column once we got the hop hocks. So now, I'll just show you how we're going to do this. So we're going to put 1, 1, 1, 1, and we can just do them like that. So that's all we have. Now, what we'll do is we'll place hop hocks in the middle there. And while this goes, it'll just keep producing. The hopper hawks will be picking up once the drum of the wild is breaking these. So that'll actually do pretty well. Now we're going to have to work out a way to kind of hide it. And I'm thinking maybe using stuff like this. We'll work out something. I think. Oh, actually, I've got a cool idea. Never mind. I've got a cool idea. It's just popped into my head now. We'll give it a try. Not just yet. Maybe tomorrow's episode. But today, this is what's going to be happening. Now, for now. let it go for today. Now the other thing I wanted to do was I've got enough of this now to make ourselves one of these. So we can make a floating jaded amaranthus. Now that should be creating a bit of light. So if we place it down again, you'll see that we shouldn't actually need these around here. May need, yep, just because that's a bit too far, but it creates a bit of light around here. And that is something that we want. So another thing which I'm pretty sure I saw could happen is if you have a look, that's just got the normal grass. If we right-click one of those, it does. That is so cool. I like that so much. We can even make it like a different color, but that's pretty cool. That was the vivid pasture seed that I just put on there, by the way. I like it. I really do. So now that's this part done. I'm thinking we got this mana pool here, and we need a way to kind of... I'm thinking maybe actually just putting it down here. Maybe we just punch this away. Well, it kind of... Yeah, that kind of could work. I don't know whether that's close enough for it to pick up to be connected here. So let's just go. Can that connect? Yes, it can. Okay, that's cool. I thought that fell through. So you see, all these flowers are being generated. Now, I'll walk away and I'll come back because there's nothing breaking this. And all these flowers should be pretty much a big 9x9 square of flowers. And what we'll do, actually, I'll just get the last little bit out of there. That equates to a half a mana pool. And this last little bit here, we'll just leave to grow. And I'll be back once I've got my stuff together. Another cool thing, which I forgot to say, which is pretty cool. And I had a look at the a video on this the other day. Is this part here, we've got a new part of our Lexica Botania. Now this is just because it's an add-on. This isn't in the normal Lexica. So when we click on that, that's called Dendrology. And it's all about making trees, which is what botanical add-ons kind of is focusing on, it looks like. So we've got the normal iridescent trees, which we've dealt with, which are now in this column here in this particular tab. The other thing is this tree suffusion, which is pretty cool. So you got a dendritic suffuser, and I had a look at it. It's pretty cool. Currently, the only thing that I can see that we can make is something called thunderous oak, which is kind of awesome. So the thunderous oak is kind of like an infused thing like this. It reminds me a lot about a lot of Thorncraft kind of... Well, I was about to fall there. Kind of reminds me of Thorncraft with their infusion, but I like it. It looks really cool. It looks pretty awesome, I must admit. So, now we can get ourselves our drum stuff together. How do we make this drum? I don't think I've made one of these in a long time. So the drums should be around here, I'm pretty sure. Are they in this column? There's the horn. And the drum, the natural apparatus. There we go. Drum of the canopy. There should be another drum around here. Drum of the wild. So we'll need 2 leather, 1 horn of the wild, 6 living wood. I'll get that stuff together and I'll be back. Okay, this is it. I've got everything. We can have a look at this now as well. Look at that. I think that looks pretty cool. All of this all filled up. Now, what we can do is we need a redstone mana spreader and we'll share it with this over here. Now, this area, how do we get this drum? Because I haven't made the drum. Oh no. We'll go get some leather and I'll show you. We're going to be making this drum now. And the thing with this is that we need to put it in a place where it'll hit everything. And I'm pretty sure majority of that area will hit everything. So that shouldn't be a problem. Then we get, I think it was just 2, but we go overboard. And we'll throw them all in here. There you go. So let's make this quickly. And we'll put one there, and then we need a horn of the wild, which I've just made. And there, we've got the drum of the wild, and that is a rod of the seas, which made an appearance as well today. Now, around here, what the plan is, really, at the beginning, we're just going to pick up all these, because we've got the ring of magnetization on. And also, I don't know how that's going to look. Maybe if I put that, maybe. Don't even know if that was a good idea, but that's all right. We do that first, and I think we've lost, yeah, we will have to put another pasture seed on it. But yeah, we do that, and that kind of maybe hides it a little bit. And that should also still work. It works, I think, 2 or 3 blocks down at least, from what I've tested out with. So if we take that, angle that at it there, and that should still be connected. Perfect. Now we need to put a hovering hourglass here, and I can work out where's a good place to put that. We'll put it on for 1 every minute. How about that? So one soul sand in will give us 1 minute, and we'll see how that goes for now. I didn't grab the hopper hocks, so that's all right. We'll imagine there's hopper hocks here. We'll just fill these up and fill up these chests now. I'll work my way out up onto it a bit later. It helps when you hold shift, by the way. There we go. So we'll place these on here. Now, after a minute, that should now break. Actually, it shouldn't break, and I'll tell you why, because I've angled that at the wrong thing. Now it should break after about a minute. So it shouldn't break everything, I don't think. It normally doesn't, but it'll break majority of the things, and we can see it. I think I might have to put it a bit lower. We'll see how that works, or maybe I'll even have to put it a bit higher over time. So that's that for now. Now the next thing I want to do was make some of that phantom ink so we can see my face. It's a very pretty face. So we'll do that now. We've got to get ourselves some of these. And not only that, we need to make ourselves... Oh, there they go. And there goes everything. I'll be back right now. Alrighty, I sorted that issue out. There was a whole bunch of that stuff around there. Now it's gone. I've placed it all just in one chest. We'll fix it up later. So we'll get back to what we were doing before we were interrupted by all those flowers. We'll need that there. And we need some stained glass. So I'll get blue stained glass, because if I'm going to use something, I'll probably use a blue stained glass for something. We need one there, one there. Bit of orange powder if I remember, or any powder, but is that it? I'm doing something wrong here. So let's go to phantom ink. So phantom ink. There it is. So I'm doing it all right. So we need the mana pearl, we need stained glass there, and dye. So maybe we need the proper dye. That's what it looks like. We need the proper dye, and we can't use this floral powder. That makes it a bit tough, but I think we got a plan, because we've got some of those daisies and stuff around. I'll eat some potato. We've moved on up out of carrots. Now we're doing normal potatoes, baked potatoes. Whereabouts did I put these? They might not have added this onto that, but we can give it a go. So we just need one of them, that there, and if not, maybe even cactus green might work. So we've got that as well to try. So was it like that? There we go. We got it. That worked. Now what we can do is it should just be pretty much craftable. So we put that in there, one of those, and you see how it still comes up like that, but nothing on me. So that's beautiful. And it looks like a minute's probably going to do it. So it's kind of just going above. It might just make it. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. I'm probably going to switch this off soon just because we haven't got everything set up, but this is kind of half done. I'll get the hopper hocks in there. That's all you need to know. And we'll pretty much call it an episode there, because I think that's done. I think we've gone over our time for today, and it really, I think, has done, I've done a bit. You guys have seen what I've done a bit, but I think we're going to be doing all right. I've got a flower in me. They'll follow me. So yeah, I think this base is coming along quite nice, so I'll keep running like this, and I'm probably going to run off the edge, but, oh, there we go. Hello. There we go. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I think this is the way we will call it. Actually, there, I've got this. So, if you guys did like it, please do leave a like as well, by the way, and thank you for all your comments. I really do love the comments on this, and I like replying to you guys. I like seeing what you guys have to say, and you guys have got a lot of good ideas. And that's not just me saying it. I actually think there's some pretty damn good ideas there. So, thank you very much, guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.